You've got to tune to the afternoon show. It's listener-powered KEXP. Kevin Cole with you. Just heard music from Perfect, the song Sometimes. That is from the EP When Squirrels Play Chicken. I think that dates back to
1900s, at least, Kevin.
Right before that, the old 97s, a song called Intervention from Most Messed Up. Tommy Stinson playing some guitar and vocals on that song, which is perfect. I always saw that as a follow-up to Treatment Bound. And started off the set with James Luther Dickinson from his 1972 release, Dixie Fried. Now, he's a legendary artist producer. He recorded with the Rolling Stones, Aretha Franklin, also just an amazing producer. He produced Big Star's Third Sister Lovers and also the Replacements album, Pleased to Meet Me. And his son, Luther, plays on the new record from Bash and Pop. Who are joining me in the studio right
yes.
now. Welcome.
Thank you for having us. Luther and I go so far back. And Steve Selvidge, the guitar player to my left, goes back that far back. He goes further back because they shared the same family, city, domicile, everything.
Yeah.
It's kind of effed records. Up if you want to know.
Did your paths cross,
Are you kidding me? Of course they did. When Luther said, I couldn't do this one gig, you should check out my buddy. And I already knew Steve was like in the whole city and stuff like that. But he's like, you got to check out Steve. And he's like my brother. And I'm like, well, what the heck, he held? And then,
ends up in your band.
You know what happened? We started calling Luther going, Thanks for the tip, dude. we were just letting him know that, we love him a whole lot. We love Luther, but thanks for Luther.
Yeah.
For giving me a Steve.
It is Bash and Pop live on the afternoon show. Tommy Stinson's band, a new project. New V2, I should say. And we're going to get into that in a sec, but you want to just blast out a couple
should
songs
Should we just
first?
Get into it?
Get into
Come
it.
Come on, Kevin, should
Let's
we get into it?
Get into it now.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Let's
Should we do another one? Yeah, this one's called On the Rocks. Unless, hey, Kevin?
Yeah.
How you doing?
I am doing fantastic. It's great having you
here.
We
didn't blow your head off yet.
No, please blow my head off.
This one here is called On the Rocks. You guys were playing this. Thank you very much. This is called On the Rocks. One, two, three. Kevin, for having us.
Oh, thank you for being here. Bash and Pop, live on the afternoon show, KEXP. Want to just keep rolling?
You want another one?
Yeah.
You want another one?
I want another one. Okay. Sounds great.
Okay, this one here is called Bad News. And it's just kind of about trying to turn some really bad crap into something good. That's it. There you go.
Bash and Pop Live on the afternoon show here. Playing tonight at Chop Suey, tomorrow night at the Doug Fir Lounge in Portland. Heading down the West Coast, eventually making it to Austin, Texas for South by Southwest. Bash and Pop, Tommy Stinson here on the afternoon show now. Tommy, Bash and Pop was your first project after the Replacements split up the first time.
It was.
In 1991. And you put out one album, and you've done a ton of things, you know, since then, including in the 2000s, two solo albums. So after this second round of, you know, Replacements shows, why'd you revive Bash and Pop after the second split versus, say, just another solo record?
Well, the thing of it was is that... It was a band record. I mean, the first when the Replacements, we never, just so you know, we never really broke up the first time. We just kind of walked away from it. And the thing was, is like we, I wanted to make a band record, right? And so I did my best with what I had at hand and all that. And I'm not trying to cast aspersions on anyone because it's, you know, it's...
Well, some of it's chemistry, right? You know, it could be very players.
There's a lot of chemistry. I had a lot of chemistry with Steve Foley and that. And the reality of it is that this record became more of a bash and pop record because of the intentions of the first one. I've made some solo records between those, and I don't like wearing too many hats. You know, it's if you're playing bass and you're playing guitar and drums and all this stuff, you know, it's a pain in the butt. And I wanted to do something real immediate. Like I wanted to like snap a two. Like let's do like we did back in the 80s. I mean, yeah. when you know you were there. You were there when we were making those you know early 80s records and stuff like that.
Yeah, they were spirited. They weren't being labored over.
We were just like, we had a moment, get in there, get in and out, because we have this place, these people coming in and out, and it's like, it was a whole thing, and that was the beauty of it, and when you think about it, you think about your favorite, I don't know, any Stones record or whatever, a lot of those records were done kind of in that way, whether it was like the whole band or part of the band or whatever, those are like, back in the day, before we had all this, you know, digital crap to do with. I mean, those were made like just like, and the reason why you like the records you like from back in the day were because of that.
Yeah, they capture the spirit and the energy.
Exactly. So, I just went back to square one.
Are the songs different? Did you feel like, hey, these songs are band songs, like, or could you have recorded those solo albums with bands?
If
you had the right people.
I couldn't have made this record without these guys.
Yeah.
These guys, the four people in this room right now, and minus one, Tony Corraldo, who's in Hudson, who's my buddy as well, plays piano and all this stuff. I couldn't have made this record without him. I mean, there's a certain way that, like, there's a certain camaraderie and a certain kind of, a thing that happens in rock and roll that, like, yeah. And mind you, I'm not pretending to be anything other than what I am. I ain't gonna start now. I ain't started 20 years ago. I'm old. It don't matter. And check it out. I got a new song here. It's called Anything Can Happen. We'll be right back. Improvising the song, the first day of our tour. Kevin, thank you for having us, man.
Oh, man, Tommy, it's so great having you.
We just started yesterday. I'm still trying to remember where I'm at.
It sounds absolutely fantastic. And you're talking about the record, man. The record, that was the title track to the album, Anything Could Happen, which is true. I mean, anything can happen when you keep that that sort of level of excitement, or the fact that
or failure, acceptance or failure.
Well, you said earlier, you know, about bad times turning crap into gold, or into gold. Man, that's what we're all trying to do, right?
Absolutely.
And that's what keeps everything alive.
My guess is most of your listeners are like on one side of this divide than the other side, and there's been plenty much to talk about. I'm about to move out of the country because of it. I think it's kind of crap. Can I do one more song for you?
Please, I would love that.
We're gonna do one more song, and it's gonna be it's something that y'all ought to check out. Look, you can't get down, and. About what's happening in our politics right now. You have to wait until the real caveat happens, and it's gonna happen soon, I think. I think these buffoons are gonna screw themselves seriously. I'm sorry, dude, I gotta go political right now.
That's a really optimistic view.
But I have a positive song for you though, Kevin.
Sweet.
I mean, it's like, this is called that. This song is called You Can't Be Anybody Else for Anybody. Let's go. It goes like this. One, two, one, two, three, four.
Counting the stars and the threads, growing up
so much for having us, man. I'm such a ball, and I love the new studio. This place is ridiculously cool.
It's amazing, right?
It's ridiculous.
It's so good.
These lights and all this stuff is fantastic.
It is Bash and Pop Live on the Afternoon Show. It's our donors. Just huge thanks to KEXP donors for making this possible.
Yeah! Woo!
It is so good. Tommy, it's so great seeing you. Thank you so much. I've been waiting for this for forever. And the new album, Anything Could Happen, sounds amazing. So
thank you, brother.
You can hear that chemistry. You can hear the spirit in the songs and the playing and the in-studio here. So, man, thank you.
Thank you so much for having us, you guys.
At Chop Suey tonight, Doug Fir in Portland tomorrow, down the West Coast, South by Southwest, catch Bash and Pop. And, man, huge thanks to Jim, Scott, Justin on video. We'll get this video up as soon as we can. Matt on photographs, a bunch of Matts. Matt running the board, Matt on hospitality, Jennifer on hospitality, Kevin Suggs on sound. It is the afternoon show again, Tommy. Man, thank you so much. Bash and Pop live on KEXP.
Thanks, buddy.
Discover great music at kexp.org.